Dear students, today I shall discuss on old literary term which is prescribed in your syllabus. Like many other literary forms, the ode is of Greek origin. The word ode has been derived from the Greek word oide, O-I-D-E. Like the lyric, the ode is a poem written to be sung or chanted by a chorus. Chorus, samugit, samugan. It is a serious and dignified composition, almost always in rhyme, and remains longer than the lyric. It is often in the form of an address, and it is used to address someone. Thus, the ode is often in form of an address, generally dignified or exalted in subject, feeling, and style. Types of odes. Greek ode has two forms, two types. First, Pindaric ode or the Dorian ode, and the second, Horatian ode or the Lesbian ode. First, Pindaric ode or the Dorian ode. The Dorian ode, which has been named after the district and dialect in which it was composed. The Dorian ode, which was successfully used by a Greek poet Pindar. In other words, the Dorian ode, which was successfully used by a Greek poet Pindar, is also called the Pindaric ode. The structure of the Pindaric ode was borrowed from the movements of the dancers. It consisted three parts: strophe, antistrophe, and epode. Strophe, at the time of recitation, the group of dancers moved from the right to the left. Antistrophe, the group of dancers moved from left to the right. Epode, the group of dancers stood still. Thus, sequence, strophe, antistrophe, and epode could be repeated many times in an ode. Gray repeats the sequence three times in his famous odes, The Progress of Poesy and The Bard. In fact, it was Pindar, a Greek poet, who successfully used it. That is why it was called the Pindaric ode. Second, the Lesbian and or Horatian ode. The Lesbian ode, which has been named after the island of Lobos, where it originally flourished. The Lesbian ode was simple in form than the Pindaric ode. Horace, the great Roman poet, popularized it, and therefore it is also known as Horatian ode. It consists many short stanzas. Catullus, a famous Roman poet, famous Roman poet also used the type of ode. The English poets have also attempted the Horatian ode with great success. Collins's Ode to Simplicity and Gray's Ode on a Distant Prospect of Eton College are some fine examples of Horatian ode in English poetry. And many English poets have also discovered other type of odes as English ode. There are few English poets who discovered new type of English odes. The English ode can be classified into two parts: regular English ode and second, irregular English ode. Regular English ode. Regular English ode consisted of a series of a similar stanzas. In other words, in regular English ode, in each stanzas the lines remain similar. Keats's Ode to Nightingale is the fine example of irregular English, a fine example of this type. And now next, irregular English ode. Each stanza follows different arrangement. Verse-verse Ode to Immortality is the fine example of irregular ode. In this way, ode has been very popular poetic form in English poetry. Generally, the theme in the ode remains very serious. That is why almost all the famous poets have expressed their thoughts in ode. That's right.